Hello friends, this is Vanjanath. In this video, I am going to talk about the DDC, that is DV Decimal Classification. It's one of the most used classification in most of the libraries, whether it is small or medium or large library. So compared to other method of classification like the Library of Congress classification, Universal Decimal Classification or Colon Classification. So DDC is most popular one. It is easy to use compared to other method of classification. So for BLIS IGNO students, we are going to use 19th edition of DDC. So till now the 23rd edition is available, but for us, for our syllabus, 19th edition is we have to use. So this 19th edition consists of volume 1, volume 2 and volume 3. Volume 1 is for introduction and tables, and volume 2 is for the schedules, and volume 3 is for the relative index. As you know, the DDC classification is used to classify the books or any other document in a library. So it is classification according to the knowledge. So DDC contains three summaries. The first summary consists of 10 main classes. First summary of 10 main classes is denoted by 0 to 9 numbers. So 0 is for generalities, 1 is for the philosophy and related disciplines, 2 is for the religion, 3 is for social science, 4 is for language, 5 is for pure science, 6 is for technology, 7 arts, 8 literature, and 9 one is for geography and histories. In actual practice, you should write it as a 0-0-0 for generalities, 1-0-0 as a philosophy and related disciplines, 2-0-0 religion, so on. So you have to use 3 digits. Don't write it in a single digit like 0 for generalities. Each of these 10 main classes further divided into 10 branches called divisions. So 10 main classes into each further divided into 10, so total 100 divisions. This is called the second summary. So second summary consists of total 100 divisions. For example, main class 300 for social science is further divided into 10 divisions. So that is 310 for statistics, 320 for political science, 330 for economics, and so on up to 390. As you know, second summary consists of 100 divisions. Each of these divisions further divided into 10 parts called sections. So total 100 divisions division into 10 sections is equal to the 1000 sections. For example, take 330 is for economics. It is further divided as 330 for economics, 331 for labor economics, 332 for financial economics, and so on up to 339 macroeconomics and related topics. So total 1000 sections are there. So this is called third summary, consist of 1000 sections.